Thanks, guys. This is a Fox News alert on dramatic testimony this morning from a current sitting attorney at the Department of Justice. Testimony given under oath that says the voting rights division at the Department of Justice is no longer in the business of justice for all. Welcome to America Live. I'm Megyn Kelly. After 12 months almost of being ordered by his bosses at the DOJ to ignore lawful subpoenas that had been served upon him, longtime DOJ attorney Christopher Coates today defied orders from his bosses and made some powerful and stunning allegations against his employer, claiming the full protection of the whistleblower statute. In testimony before the U.S. Commission on Civil Rights about a voter intimidation case from 2008, Coates offered evidence under oath that race and politics are driving decisions at the Department of Justice. Take a listen.
Ms. Fernandez responded by telling the gathering in there that the Obama administration was only interested in bringing traditional types of Section 2 cases that would provide equality for racial and language minority voters. And then she went on to say that this is what we are all about, or words to that effect.
In other words, Mr. Coates testifying that there is a mandate within the Department of Justice not to enforce the voting rights laws for the benefit of white victims. Steve Sentani, live in Washington. He's been following the hearing all morning. Steve, what did we learn?
Well, Christopher Coates at first did not want to testify. He's now testifying before the U.S. Commission on Civil Rights with some damning testimony about a culture of injustice inside the Justice Department. As he puts it, there's a long-term hostility to race-neutral enforcement of the Voting Rights Act. That is, the policy is the unwritten but sometimes spoken policy, made very clear to him anyway, he says, is that minorities will be protected when it comes to voting rights, but not necessarily whites, that all the emphasis, all the focus should go toward minorities. So that's the main thrust of what he said today. He made some very strong allegations against some of the people who have this belief in the Justice Department, who have now risen to higher positions in the Obama administration and who are in control here. Let's listen to one more thing that Christopher Coates says here.
We agree with Mr. Adams that there is a culture in the voting section or in the Civil Rights Division broadly hostile to the enforcement of voting laws on behalf of white victims.
Yes, I believe that. I don't think that it exists to the same degree with every employee in the voting section, and there's some employees in the voting section who do not agree, but that generally there has been that pattern of hostility that is reflective also of the point of view of the some of the major civil rights groups.
He also said at one point that the Civil Rights Division of the Justice Department is nothing but crowd pleasers for the civil rights groups. And although some Obama administration officials are now in high positions where he believes they hold this opinion, this goes back, of course, all the way into the Bush years, where there were some people in the Justice Department who tried to block prosecution of a corrupt leader, voting rights leader down in Mississippi, and into the Clinton administration, too. So this is not new, but he's saying this has been intensified by some of the appointees Mr. Obama has made. Back to you, Megyn.
Steve, what has been the response of the Department of Justice? Because we had earlier months ago J. Christian Adams, another whistleblower from the Department of Justice, right, come out and make very similar allegations, and they came out and dismissed him as having distorted the facts and saying that he had an agenda, all because he happens to be a conservative. Chris Coates has worked for Democratic and Republican administrations. He used to head the ACLU's voting rights division, then headed the DOJ's voting rights divisions. What is the Department of Justice saying about Chris Coates, who is still, to this moment, a DOJ attorney?
That's right. He's been moved down to South Carolina. He's no longer in charge of the Voting Rights Division. But what they say is they do enforce the Voting Rights Act equally. It's not, as Chris Coates claims, simply devoted to protecting minorities, but to protecting all voters all across the country. So that's their claim. And they had give their specific reasons for dismissing the case of the Black Panthers in Philadelphia during the voting in 08. So they have made their defense. But they also have made it clear They do not want Coates to testify, and yet here he is today.
Indeed. It's an extraordinary move by him. He's resisted. He's listened to his boss's orders since last December, and my sources tell me he had had enough, that he couldn't let this inquiry go on one day longer without coming forward and giving the testimony that had been subpoenaed of him. Steve Sentani, thank you. Folks, this case goes way beyond the new Black Panther Party case. It has almost nothing to do with that anymore. It has now come down to this. Two Department of Justice attorneys, one current and one recently former, are saying that the Department of Justice will not enforce the voting rights laws of this country where the victim of voter intimidation or in other sections of the law is white. That Caucasians will not be provided the benefit of the voting rights laws, even though the mandate from Congress is quite the opposite. Justice is supposed to be blind, even when it comes to voting rights laws. That's the allegation. The Department of Justice denies that and says that's just not true. They haven't spoken specifically to Coates to malign him, but they did try to malign J. Christian Adams, as I told you moments ago. Chris Coates' testimony getting a lot of attention today, and coming up on this broadcast, two of the commissioners who sit on that panel, this panel is basically the only one that's even looking into any of this, they will join me live. Both sides will be represented. The panel breaks down along sort of party lines, and there's some, you know, left-leaning and some right-leaning. We're going to have one from each side to represent the various positions and talk about where this case could go in just a bit.